This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, oh, we are so lucky. Chef George Doumaney from Portsmouth Publick House is back. Good morning, sir.
Good morning.
Always a pleasure to see you. It's been too long.
Can you tell my wife she's lucky?
Oh, she's extremely lucky.
Really?
Oh, I'll
really?
Shout her from the mountaintops is what I will do. But today, my friend, we are making mushroom risotto, right?
Mushroom risotto.
All right. Take us down ingredient lane.
It's a very classic dish.
Great.
You know, risotto is it's a type of rice. It's a Boreal rice. It's a little bit more fuller and thicker.
Right.
And when you cook it and you cook it properly, it comes out creamy
right.
and tasty and delicious, you know.
Cool.
But it's a process to cook. It's very easy to do. Anyone can make it.
Cool.
It's super simple. It's obviously the arborio rice, the risotto.
Mm-hmm.
You want to do two or three different types of mushrooms.
All right.
We've got red onions and shallots, garlic, salt, pepper, olive oil, and then wine.
Now, is this part of the new fall menu with the Portsmouth
Yeah, Cookhouse? We have this menu that I'm working on. I'm really focusing on gluten-free and vegan and vegetarian. This is all of the above. This is gluten-free, this is a vegetarian dish, and it's vegan because there's no animal byproduct in this whatsoever.
Outstanding. And I was in the Publick House recently. I got a little sneak peek at the new fall menu. Lots of nice, great, cool things coming up.
Yeah, it's amazing. Well, we've had a huge response. We've run the menu now for 2 weeks, and there's an amazing response on it.
So and just to remind everyone out there, of course, the location where they can find you.
It's in Portsmouth, Rhode Island, obviously, Portsmouth
Good
Publick
place
House.
For it.
And it's the physical address is 600 Clock Tower Square.
Awesome. Well, you will take us through the steps as only you can do, masterfully, teaching even a guy like me how this is done. It's going to be great. I can't wait to sample it. This is Chef George Doumaney from the Portsmouth Publick House. He's here all morning. Mushroom risotto. What's better? For now, back to you. Send it back into the kitchen where Will awaits with Chef George.
Yes, I do. We are back in the Rhode Show kitchen. This morning, Chef George is here. Portsmouth Publick House is the place. And mushroom risotto is on the menu. And man, the second you walk in here, you smell the garlic.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Yeah.
But it smells great.
Well, you know, because it's there's no animal byproduct in it, you want to give it a really good punch with flavors. So I always go heavy with garlic on it. I always add a little extra pepper to it. So it's not spicy because the rice that's inside of it, it's just... It's a transport for the flavor, so the rice is just going to suck all of those flavors in.
Got it.
You know, then we add the dry white wine.
Mm-hmm.
I personally like cooking with dry Riesling because it's a little sweet, but it's not too sweet.
Doesn't overpower it.
Yeah, and it's fantastic to cook with because it gives a nice flavor.
Good. Well, it smells good here. So now you're going to show us the proper way to take care of the mushroom, right?
Yeah. So what happens is you get these big portobello mushrooms in, and they've got all of these gills, and they're kind of like, you know, people get a little freaked out because, you know, can I eat that or not? But the mushroom itself, it's a beautiful mushroom.
Mm-hmm.
It's nice and thick and flavorful. And it's a good meat substitute as well because it's so thick.
Right.
It doesn't break down like a normal mushroom. So what we do in the restaurant, right, is you take the gills and you just want to...
Oh, they come off really easy.
Just scrape it with a spoon.
Yeah.
You know, and you just throw it in there. And then, you know, you just discard the gills.
Okay. Put them in there.
And that's it.
And easy enough to do.
And easy enough to do. And then you clean it all up, and then you just dice it up, and you throw it in your pot to
and
cook
And you're good
with.
To go. Now, so that's what we're using. We're using both of these types in here, right?
Yep, I'm using both regular white mushrooms and portobellas.
Okay.
You could use shiitakes. You could use cantrells.
Okay.
Those are fantastic. You want to have a nice flavorful mix. You want more than one mushroom so it balances it out and gives a nice flavor.
Got it.
And then the same thing with the onions. I use two different types of onions, right? I use the shallot and I actually use the red onion.
Okay. So also both, two different types of flavors.
Yeah, exactly. They're both from the red onion family.
Mm-hmm.
Just the shallot is a little bit sweeter. It has that mild onion flavor where the red onion is, again, it gives you that sucker punch of that really, that nice flavor.
All good. Well, man, it smells pretty good in here this morning as we cook up this mushroom risotto with Chef George from Portsmouth Publick House. We're going to talk more about the restaurant, put it all together just a little bit. Back to you. Smells pretty fantastic this morning in the Rhode Show kitchen. Chef George is here. Portsmouth Publick House is the place, and we got a mushroom risotto on the menu today. And, man, talk about a great fall dish. This guy has done it, put it together. Perfect for this time of year.
Yeah, it is. It's absolutely perfect. And, you know, the benefit of doing the mushroom risotto, actually, is that right now is the best time. All the great mushrooms are coming out. They're so thick and flavorful. And they're local. A lot of them are local right now because of the moisture in the air and in the ground.
Mm-hmm.
So they come out great. The only issue with risotto, when we're making risotto, is it's one of these dishes that you're committed to, you can never leave the stove.
Right.
Because what happens is the starch releases from the liquid, and if you just step away for a second, it's just going to bind right to the bone.
You've got to monitor the entire process.
The whole process, yep. And it's one of these things when you're cooking it, it's all by look.
Well, okay.
You know, because you have to add the liquid a little bit by a time. I did very, very, very detailed. Actually, it's probably the most detailed recipe I've ever put on the Rhode Show website, just so people understand the whole process of, you know, you put a half a cup of a time as you wait for the water to evaporate, or I'm using vegetable stock to keep it vegan.
You know what it looks like? A steaming cauldron of flavor.
Yeah, it is.
It looks tremendous.
Yeah.
That's right. Hashtag steaming cauldron of flavor. But where are we in the prep process?
So it's actually done. All I did was I took the mushroom that Will and I cleaned out. I diced it up. I threw it into the pan with the two onions.
Okay.
Sauteed them down. Added a little bit of dry white wine.
Right.
Added my my risotto.
Okay.
Little olive oil. Sauteed it up. And
you're good to go.
Awesome.
Two different types of onions. You said just in there. You got the red onion, the shallot in there.
Exactly. And then what you can do is when you're cooking with this, or you can make the risotto the actual entree.
Right.
And that's it. There you don't have maybe some vegetables, a salad, or what we do at the Portsmouth Publick House is we actually serve a nice piece of braised short rib on it.
Sounds good to me, my man.
Something like that.
Can I stir a little bit?
Yeah,
no, sounds good to
me. Actually, you stir.
All right.
Okay. And I'm going to take this. I pulled some aside already.
And chef, after a while, it'll thicken up a little bit more.
Absolutely. I'm rushing it in the studio, obviously, because it's live TV.
Right.
And but it's as you can see right here, it's like actually becoming nice and thick.
Am I ruining it?
No.
Oh, good.
And what's going to happen is the liquid's going to incorporate with the starch, and it's going to actually become more of a creamy substance.
And people put all together.
So because of TV and we ran short on time.
Hey, I got to tell you, just looking at this here, even without the braised short rib on top, it looks really good.
Yeah.
And this is the time of year you come in here. You come in here on Wednesdays and cook for us, but you make kind of like stick to your ribs, great hearty food, especially during the fall.
Yeah, myself and my culinary team, we believe in, old school cooking.
Everything's
made from scratch. We don't skimp. Mm-hmm. You know, it has to be hearty, and it's got to be delicious.
You get a nice, generous portion when you come in. I've been in many times, and it's always plenty.
He's been in a lot of times, trust me.
That may be a restraining order in place if he keeps coming.
I think there should be a plaque. I wouldn't be in the first place. I think there should be a plaque on the seat where I like to sit.
Come on, there's a plaque there. All right, good.
Whatever it takes.
Just curb you. Please don't come.
Yeah, I'm glad I've been coming in.
So what's going on at the restaurant?
Yeah, we have our live music every Saturday.
Sure.
The girls are amazing that play for us. It's all acoustical. They're fantastic. Mm-hmm. Thursdays, we have trivia. And then
Brendan's nodding because I'm assuming he's been there
Brendan was there last week for trivia.
I'm sure he was.
As intelligent as we all think he is, right? Yeah. I don't think he got one answer right.
I got every answer right in the movie year category, if you were scoring at home. But we'll have this recipe at WPRI.com. Portsmouth Publick House is the place. This is the great chef, George Doumaney. Mushroom risotto. It smells great. For now, back over to you.